Por el bienestar de mi familia, para pues poder tener ya nada más un trabajo, porque por el momento tengo dos, y ya con un trabajo y ganando los $15 podría yo pasar más tiempo con mi familia, cuidando a mis hijos, conviviendo más con ellos.
Hay empleadores que nos gritan, que nos abusan a muchos de nosotros, que nos ponen a hacer una cosa cuando en verdad nos contratan por otra cosa. Muchas personas ganan 8.25, 8.50, que es lo mínimo. El transfer sube, la gasolina sube, la comida sube, muchas cosas suben. ¿Te imaginas qué puedes hacer con $15 la hora? Muchas cosas.
I moved to Chicago for school. I couldn't afford to stay at Columbia, so I left, went back home, moved back here, and attended Harold Washington. I was homeless my first month I was here. I just got another place, or like in September. But recently, like a month ago, I went through almost being evicted because I wasn't getting paid enough at my job. Hours were getting cut and only making $8.75 an hour, and only working like 12, 10 hours a week was not making enough to pay my rent. So I also had to drop out of school this semester because I had to pick up a second job. So making $15 an hour also would mean being able to have a stable job, only one job, because that way I can go to school.
Workers in the downtown area have gone out on strike this morning.
It's a job action. They're aimed at trying to get higher pay or a living wage, as they call it. Joni Lum is live at Union Station there at Adams and Connell. So tell us more about what they're doing. Hey, Joni, good morning.
Good morning. This is just one place where you're going to find some demonstrations, picket lines, some people protesting. They're going to be showing up at McDonald's and Subway and Dunkin' Donuts. They're also going to be on the Magnificent Mile, Macy's, Sears, and Victoria's Secret, because all these retail workers say that they're working hard and they're being professionals, but they're not getting paid a professional wage. For those commuters who are coming into Union Station, this might affect their daily routine today, especially if they're going to try to get coffee at one of those places where the people have walked off. The demonstrators delivered a strike notice to the McDonald's inside Union Station at 5:30 this morning. Protesters say that retail businesses pay about minimum wage, which is only $8.25 in Illinois, but meantime, they're raking in the big bucks as a business.
I work at Sears. I make $9 an hour. The challenge is I'm raising two children by myself. It's not enough.
I mean, since I've been here, I've only gotten, for 2 years I've been here. And since those 2 years, I've gotten a 46-cent raise altogether.
I am being taken advantage of, not just me, but my coworkers as well. I mean, I see them every day and myself too. Like, we work so hard, you know, to bring profit to the company.
Tonight, let's also recognize that there are communities in this country where no matter how hard you work, it is virtually impossible to get ahead. Factory towns decimated from years of plants packing up, inescapable pockets of poverty, urban and rural, where young adults are still fighting for their first job. America is not a place where the chance of birth or circumstance should decide our destiny. But today, a full-time worker making the minimum wage earns $14,500 a year. Even with the tax relief we put in place, a family with two kids that earns the minimum wage still lives below the poverty line. That's wrong. That's why, since the last time this Congress raised the minimum wage, 19 states have chosen to bump theirs even higher. Tonight, let's declare that in the wealthiest nation on earth, no one who works full-time should have to live in poverty.
We ask your special blessing on these workers who are struggling for just wages and working conditions, not only for themselves, but for all who labor. Bless the hands of these, your children, that prepare the meals, handle the merchandise, work the cash registers, and carry the burden of life. Fill them with courage and clarity of vision that they may continue persevere in your ways of justice and peace on this day and every day until every woman, every man, every child, every family can be assured a living wage. wage and the right to organize.
The fight for better pay and respect in the workplace means higher wages for workers, means that they can provide food, shelter, and clothing for their families, and then improve our economy for everyone.
La pelea por los salarios mínimos significa que nosotros podemos como familia proveerles mejor comida, salud y educación a nuestros hijos.
En un principio como que estaban un poco con, como que les dijeron que no me hablaran, las managers me trataban un poco mal, pero ahorita ya todo cambió. Ya ahorita, si me quieren mandar para mi casa o me dicen, ¿puedes, te quieres ir o no? Y ya, lo que les conteste yo ya. Y en el otro McDonald's también ahorita hubo muchos cambios. Ya nos dan la comida gratis. Ya ahorita tenemos 2 semanas que nos están dando nuestras 8 horas, que porque ya es una orden que nos tienen que respetar nuestro sketcho. Pues están contentos, la verdad, me felicitan. Mi niña, más que nada, ella me ve y me dice que me veo hermosa y que se siente muy orgullosa de mí, y pues me da más ánimo para seguir.
It shook a lot of people up. I know it did, and it got a lot of attention. You know, they might have heard rumors, but for it to actually happen and for them to see so many companies and so many people coming together for the same situation, I mean, I personally don't know how it is for anybody else, like at Nordstrom's Rack or Sears or anything, but at Macy's, it's definitely been a change. I have got a 25-cent raise. The base salary that I was receiving was $8.25 an hour. So now it's $8.50, and I also went from part-time to full-time at Macy's department store.
Sí, la verdad que sí estoy muy confiada en que sí vamos a ganar y le vamos a echar ganas para que otros compañeros como yo que sufren humillaciones que se unan a nuestra causa y que sigan adelante, que no se dejen humillar.
You know that your fight is not a fight that you have to fight alone anymore. And that unity and that brotherhood, sisterhood, camaraderie, whatever you want to call it, you are able to go back to work and just feel like you're still connected to something, you know? And this is not even just for the 5 for 15, this is just period. Well, I'm not alone anymore because I'm one phone call away from about 200 people who will be ready to just send it up in here just for me. And this is not just me, this is that person and that person and that person. It's like a big family, you know? Like, you doing something with one person, all of us care and all of us are coming. You do this to her, oh, guess what? All of us are coming. It's not just her anymore. And we're willing to stand up and say that for any one of these one people who are a member. And besides just that, then we're coming together and we're doing something positive, not just for our generation, but for future generations after this one. I mean, who can't be proud of themselves to be a part of something like that? I mean, my kids could be reading about us in history books when they get in school, or my grandkids. And I mean, for a low-income African-American woman living in the worst neighborhood in Chicago, that kind of makes you feel a little bit differently about yourself. You don't feel so much like a statistic anymore. So I mean, I can't say that I'm not happy about anything.